The election results in Mahaska County Supervisor's race are official, and Republican Mark Doland is the winner.
I, Mark Doland,
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
Doland was immediately sworn in following the 20-minute-long canvassing process. The final tally of the votes resulted in 1,398 for Republican Mark Doland and 1,377 for Democrat Tom Riley. We asked Doland about his first reaction on winning the election.
Well, it was a very tight race there since last Tuesday, and I'm glad to have that behind me, and I'm excited to start my new role as county supervisor.
Doland's first order of business will be a budget work session tomorrow at the courthouse.
Try to get that where it needs to be, because they have to have their budget certified by certain date anyhow, so it's going to be jumping in with both feet, I guess, right off the bat.
In response to the election outcome, Tom Riley released a statement on his Facebook page saying, "I want to commend Mark on a well-run campaign, and I sincerely wish him the best as he begins his new role. Unfortunately, we came up 21 votes short. That being said, I have absolutely no regrets, and I am proud of the campaign we ran." Mahaska County Auditor Sue Brown said last week we would learn the results of the election today during a canvassing of the vote in the County Board of Supervisors meeting. The county had to wait until all absentee ballots were in and counted. The supervisor meeting started at 9 o'clock with a resolution for the county to be withdrawn from RUS. RUS stands for Regional Utility Service Systems. That's a group of 10 organizations formed to allow the sharing of services, if needed. Those services include sewer systems, for example.
We don't serve any county residents through RUS. We never have. I think they're doing diligent in turning RUS around. They've had financial issues in the past, but this really isn't an indictment on that at all. It's really more of an issue of protecting the taxpayers. So, I mean, we still are part of an organization which we pay fees to that we don't receive any services.
Supervisors Greg Gordy and Mike Vandermolen voted to have the county withdrawn from RUS. The supervisors also approved the second reading for changes to the general relief ordinance. The ordinance provides help with basic needs such as shelter, food, and utilities. Those changes increase the amount given for those needs. The last time the ordinance was updated was 1998. No public comments were made, and the third reading is set for the next meeting. The board heard a report from county conservationist Dave Sedevec. Sedevec says the county received $25,000 from an estate donation. That's money that will be spent toward improvements at Robertson's Access, which is located north of New Sharon. Sedevec also reported that the county hosted 64 education programs attended by 318 adults and 1,410 children. The board then heard from county road engineer Jerry Nussbaum. Nussbaum told the board that Ragbri would be coming into Oskaloosa from the southwest corner of town on Indian Way Road, which goes through Beacond, and says that while Indian Way is structurally sound, it's still a rough road. He recommended accelerating a plan to do an asphalt overlay on the road. And that's what happened during the supervisors' meeting on this Monday, February 4th, 2013. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Aaron Riggs.